When nature declares war, why shouldn't humans fight back? And why not fight back with nuclear bombs? At one point, the US government discussed just that by suggesting the detonation of nuclear bombs inside of hurricanes. But why wait for nukes? Maybe you should just take matters into your own hands.
As Hurricane Irma hits Florida, local police are warning residents not to shoot at the storm. More than 28,000 people RSVP'd yes to a Facebook event called Shoot at Hurricane Irma. The event's creator told the BBC he started it as a joke, and while you'd hope most people would get the sarcasm, he admitted the whole thing's gotten a little out of hand.
Hurricanes can be extreme. With violent winds, torrential rain, and storm surges that can batter coastlines, hurricanes are testaments to nature's immense power. A power so immense that some people said, actually, I think I'm stronger. Or, in other words, shooting the hurricane with a gun, or even nuking them into oblivion. I know you all probably know that it's a bad idea, because it is, and that most of these people won't actually do it, but let me explain the science behind why neither option would work. Let's consider the basic physics of hurricanes. These storms are fueled by warm ocean water, and their energy is released through condensation of water vapor. Shooting bullets at a hurricane would be like putting out a fire with a drop of water. The amount of energy you need to essentially cancel out or overcome the hurricane's energy is incredible. I know that's a gross oversimplification, but come on, we're talking about shooting hurricanes. So yeah, a few bullets, even thousands of bullets, would have negligible impacts on the storm's vast amount of energy. Now let's talk about the more plausible, strong irony in my voice here, option, which is nuking hurricanes, because nukes are more powerful than guns, right? Well, detonating a nuke near a hurricane would have catastrophic consequences. The radioactive fallout would quickly travel along trade winds and contaminate vast amounts of land and sea, poisoning the environment and endangering countless lives, lives that are probably already at risk from the hurricane itself. Now here's the craziest part. The US government did briefly consider the idea of nuking hurricanes, but admittedly not very seriously. In 1961, the then head of the US Weather Bureau, Francis W. Reicheldelfer, hey, editor Peter here, there's no way that I actually pronounced his name correctly. I re-listened to the audio and it sounds ridiculous, but I have no idea how to pronounce it, so I'm gonna stick with that. Said, quote, imagine the possibility someday of exploding a nuclear bomb on a hurricane far at sea. The main difficulty with using explosives to modify hurricanes is the amount of energy required. A fully developed hurricane can release heat energy at a rate of 5 to 20 times 10 to the 13th power watts, and converts less than 10% of that heat into the mechanical energy of the wind. The heat release from the hurricane is equivalent to a 10 megaton nuclear bomb exploding every 20 minutes. According to the 1993 World Almanac, the entire human race used energy at a rate of 1,013 watts in 1990, a rate less than 20% of the power of a hurricane. So, okay, maybe we don't nuke hurricanes at their peaks. Maybe we can nuke them as they're still developing, right? Again, not so much. Only about 5% of tropical disturbances become hurricanes, meaning it's really hard to guess which ones become hurricanes. And nuking every tropical storm that pops up would be catastrophic, not to mention that tropical storms themselves still carry a lot of power. With all that in mind, please don't shoot at hurricanes. Early warning systems, robust infrastructure, and well-coordinated evacuation plans are far more effective in saving lives and minimizing damage. Investing in research to better understand and predict hurricane behavior can also help us develop more targeted and effective mitigation strategies. Ultimately, humans feel empowered to bend the very forces of the universe to our will, but that kind of hubris can be unsuccessful at best and have catastrophic consequences at worst.